In the next couple of videos, I'm going to explain how to make Pong. And the reason we're going to make a game is very simple. Practice. If you want to learn how to code games, then making games is the best way to practice. The goal of this tutorial is to show how to make a game with the tools you've learned so far. It's not to teach you how to make Pong. It's to teach you to think like a programmer. When you ask an experienced programmer to create Pong, he doesn't look up how to make Pong. He already knows how to make Pong. This is because Pong, and this counts for all games, is made out of problems. And the experienced programmer recognizes these problems and is confident that he can solve them. An example problem, the pad needs to move up and down when you press the up and down arrow key. You actually already did this once in episode 7. Do you still know how to do it? If not, that's okay. You will forget how to do certain things from time to time. But keep practicing and eventually you'll be able to create Pong and all kinds of games without a tutorial. I want to do a quick recap of everything I've taught you so far. Variables. Words where we can store values in. Numbers, strings, booleans, functions, tables, they're all variables. One thing I want to make clear is that LOVE or Lua does not care for the names of your variables. If I call a variable X and Y, I do so because it makes sense. But I could also have named them Laser Bear and Space Pirate. Functions. Allows us to repeat pieces of code. Functions can have parameters. What you pass to these parameters is called arguments. So in this case, I pass the argument 10 to the parameter x. Functions can return a value. With functions, it's important to note that with parentheses, you're calling the function and the returned value is used. Without, you're using the function itself. If statements. With if statements, you can set a condition on pieces of code. In my video, I said if statements check if the value is true, but it's better to say that it checks if it's not false. There are two values that count as false, the boolean false and nil, no value. This means that a number, a string, a table, even a function, anything that is not false or nil, counts as true. Tables. Tables are lists you can store values inside. You can use brackets to access those values. You can also use names to access and assign values to the table. Of course, a table can have any kind of value. Numbers, strings, functions, tables. This means that a table can have a table. And that table can also have a table. It never ends. We can store values when creating the table by putting them inside the curly brackets, with table.insert, or with brackets. Local variables. Local variables are limited to their scope. This is basically the start of a file, function, if statement, for loop, etc. till the end. If you have a local variable inside an if statement and a for loop inside that if statement, then you can use the local variable in the for loop as well, because we can use the local variable till the end of this if statement. Libraries. Libraries are scripts with the goal to make things easier for you. Everyone can make a library. There are also libraries built into Lua. These are called standard libraries. This includes basically every object and function Lua already has, like print, require, table.insert. Classes. Classes are like blueprints. We use the blueprint to create an instance. Changing the instance does not affect the blueprint. We can extend a class, meaning that we copy the blueprint and draw on top of it. A lot of programming languages come with classes. For Lua, we use a library to simulate classes. One extra thing I want to explain really quick is comments. When you type two minus signs, you're starting a comment. Everything that is typed behind these signs is not part of your code. We can type anything we want and it won't give us an error. For the code, it's as if it was never there. This is useful for when you want to add information on what you're doing in your code. I made a list of code that I put in the description and I commented each part. Hopefully it's helpful to you if you forget how something works. At the release of this video, I have about 100 subscribers. That's not a whole lot, but each subscriber makes me a bit more motivated to make these videos, so thank you. I try to remember what I struggled with when I learned how to code and pass that on in my videos. But if you don't understand something, you can always ask in the comments. I also encourage you to try out things for yourself. I haven't explained images and audio yet, but I wouldn't be surprised if you figured that out by yourself by now. That's it for this video. I hope you're looking forward to the Pong tutorial and thanks for watching.